Hello, 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 let me turn this down right here. This lovely, lovely little music we got going on. Welcome to another Tuesday game design stream. That's right, this one is probably going to be a very short stream. I'm thinking maybe 30 minutes to an hour is what I'm estimating it to be at. Basically, what we have here in front of us right here, right above my head, interface. That's right. So, interface. I guess we're doing the menu. We're not doing the actual game board yet. That might have to be done a different time. So what I'm thinking is I have a program on my computer. It's called draw.io. It's essentially a program that how do I describe it? The best thing I can describe it as is a piece of software that lets you make diagrams for things. I have personally used it for UML diagrams, which are these programming diagrams that basically show certain systems communicating with other systems. It just helps visualize what needs to happen in the code before you go do it. So when you're coding, yes, diagrams are important. They're very important. I see them every day in work at my programming job. Especially when we're designing stuff for new things to be added. There's always got to be a diagram that goes with it. Very, very important. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. Probably just a simple diagram. And Astra, how you doing? Oh, I should make the wonderful. I am doing good as well too. I was quite tired today at work. Like very, very tired at work today for some reason. I don't know why. It was weird because I think before Senpai's stream the other day. Like, I wanted to watch the beginning of it, but I went to go lay down and I like napped for an hour. I was just like, I went to lay down in my bed and my bed was very warm and I fell asleep for an hour. So. Yes. So. We are going, I don't know how I want to, like, I'm thinking of doing this like sort of UML style, but I'm also thinking of not doing it. I don't think I want to do it UML style because it's not really programming style. I think I should do it this way. So let's assume, wish I could type in this box. Oh, I can type in this box. Cool. Yes, I have, what is it? It's like, a down comforter? It's sort of like a down comforter, except it's not a down comforter. It's just a very big, heavy Uggs blanket, and it's very comfy. It's very fuzzy and warm, and it was great because it was raining the other day. Or it started raining last night. So this would be main menu. That could be bold. Main menu. Alright, so what do we expect in our main menu? Honestly, I think the thing about, I always like going to bed, listen, like if it's like a really windy rain, like that's the best kind of rain to go to sleep to, because it's just like, it's great white noise and it's very easy to fall asleep to. It's just a very, there is something soothing about it. There was also, I think, like a time when I was in college, and wait, it was snowing, and it was like the very, very light snow, and like I went outside when I was doing that. There was like no cars on the street. There was nobody outside. It was kind of like eerily quiet yet calming at the same time. It was a very weird feeling, but it was like you stepped out and didn't. It was just very, very eerie. So, main menu, start menu. Yeah, it was pretty cool, because it was like, you could just stare and eat, like, no direction, no cars, no nothing, nobody was there. It was eerie, but cool at the same time. Start menu. What? I'm dumb. Why did I type start menu? That should say start game, not start menu. The main menu is the start menu. Lake fog for me, eerie, but yeah, I don't know. I see fog so often, it's yeah, that's what to say. I don't know. I see fog so often because of where I live, but I feel like if it's like foggy and it's like early morning, yeah, that can be eerie. Start game, probably save game, and load game. I forget, it's like, do games usually have the load game above the save game? Aww. I feel like you would just have load game on the main menu and not save game. Although probably you should do both on them. So I'll do save game. What game was that, and why would it be in the far right corner? This just seems like a weird place to put it. This is very weird. Never. Like, typically it's like in the actual menu. Like, I don't... An indie game from early 2000s. I guess that would make sense. Early 2000, yeah, games. Games were just in their, infancy around then? Like, I don't even... All I remember from early games is Pokemon and F-Zero. That's what I remember. I remember being bad at F-Zero, because I would tilt the Game Boy... And try and turn, like, little, whatever, the F-Zero racer thing, car, floaty thing. You know, the child me, just thinking, I can turn. If I turn the device, it'll turn in the game too. But that's not how games work. What does my Word document say? Throw my Word document onto my other monitor. What do we have? Start game, load game, save game, settings. Settings are important. Setting the volume to lower volumes would also be helpful. Settings. Achievements. Should there... Do I put an achievement thing on the main page? I feel like if I was to put, okay. Oh, you have a cat. That's cool. I like cats. I'm a cat. Just kidding. I'm not a cat. I'm a VTuber cat. And that's what I am. Technically, this is just my blob form. Settings, exit to desktop. Here we go. Got ourselves a nice little what kind of cat is he? I'm always curious about what kind of cats peoples have. Because, like, I don't know. Every cat's different. Plus, I love cats. Cats are such an adorable little creature. Thus, I became one. He's a black kitty we got at the shelter when he was a kitten. His name is Donnie. But call him Grandpa. That's funny. Grandpa Donnie, the black cat. No. I keep turning and hitting my microphone by accident. Oh. Uh-oh. Undo that. Yes, very judgmental. I had Rayless look at. Rayless came up with when he was doing his like alternate lore, or not alternate lore, when he was doing Guess the VTuber lore stuff, he did mine and guessed I was like, I don't know, some like thing that judges you when you die. It was really funny. It's like my alternate lore is that I'm like, I judge you when you die, and then this is my face when I judge you. That's funny. I think. Yes, the best part. Just smile. Just smile and stare into people's souls. Well. And then I got other things that I rarely use these, such as. Got sparkly eyes. We got the shock face. The hearts. We got the. Oh no. Why? Why have we done such a thing? No. And then we have the angry face that kind of blends in with my color. Hey, I'm walking here. I'm walking. What you doing? Yeah, I don't know. If anything, I should change the color of it. Make it, I don't know. I don't know what color it would be to change that to. Neon pink? Yeah, probably. That would probably pop out of red. Okay, so I think this is a good start to achievement. That's definitely not how you spell achieve. Is that how you spell that? No, that's definitely not how you spell that. I'm missing an E. You're a writer, right? So, like, do you ever, like, go and you, like, look at a word and the more you stare at it, the more you think you have spelled the word wrong, but it's actually spelled right? Like, I feel like I stare at words in English and then the more you look at it, it's just like, is that word correct? And then you go, that can't be correct. Then you go Google it and then you're like, it's correct? And you just continue looking at it and it just gets worse. So this will be game. Melancholy.
words?
I think it's like words with like, I don't know. Maybe it's like the C, I, and E like near each other is sometimes what messes me up. No, start game. Can go to game. And then the game is going to have a pause menu. Pause menus are quite important. Yeah. Yep, nope. Nope, I know. I had an English teacher in college. Because I did not proofread any of my essays I turned in. She thought English was my second language, which is the only language I speak. And thank you. Yes. This diagram is just, I'm just trying to plan out, just to have a diagram, because I'm going to end up making, I'm at a point where I want to make a video of like the initial design that I have done. Yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah, it's essentially going to be just a collection of what I did. I don't. Basically, I'm gonna look at all of my streams, take the document I did, and be like, this is how you start designing a game. Yeah, it's just, games are very, very, I guess you could say games are its own art form that takes other art forms, because you have to have a combination of writing, actual art, and you have the technical side of programming. There's just so much that goes into a game that I think sometimes people don't realize. So, game, this will be game menu. True, one of my English professors had us play a game and talk about the art of it. What game, if I may ask, if you remember? Always curious. It's always interesting to see what other people think of games. Because everybody has their own opinion of games. Should have a resume button. It's a small indie game called Today I Die. And is a poetic game. Short but very good. I'll maybe have to check it out and see it. And see what I think about it. Interesting. There's wonder if that would, I don't know if that would fall under. So there's a category of games that are called serious games, which are games that fall under, basically they're trying to teach you something of value. So they could be like about healthcare, or they could be about, I think like the example we played was like something about like a war in Africa. It was this whole interesting category of games that you wouldn't think would be games. I guess you could, a serious game would be the best example I can think of that I think many people would know, would be like Brain Age from like the very, very old Nintendo DS. Ah, yes. What is it? I think on that, I did do a game in college as part of the serious games course that I took with, in a group, was we made a game about about depression. It was basically a visual novel that had like multiple paths that you could take, just to like teach the person that was playing it about different things they could say or basically what they should and shouldn't say to someone who has depression. What did I write game design in my box? So resume, save game. Oh, did you want to load the game? Gonna get some loading shenanigans going on. That's fine to have. Load game. Yeah, I'll check it out after stream. When I got time. Let's see, another box. Box. What else do we need? Controls. It's a flash game. Did it? Yeah, I feel like a lot of the old flash games just... I thought Adobe... Or what was it? Don't flash games not really exist? I could have sworn because... Hello, Bertil. How are you? How's it going? We're making diagrams and talking about serious games. That's excellent. What did I say we need here? Controls. I don't know how controls will fit. I'm good. Enjoying life. A little bit tired today, but that's... I don't know why I'm tired, honestly. Very weird. Very, very weird. Controls. We got our wonderful audio controls. I'm running out of space. I'm gonna squish these together. Squish. Need lots and lots more space. Wonderful. Here we go. Wow. Wonderful. Okay. So we got audio control. I guess we should just call that audio instead of audio control, because that's what it is in video games usually. Bam, bam, diagram, ma'am. Oh. Video, and then you have your typical exit to main menu and desktop. Go exit to main menu. This gets a nice little line. Wait, are these connected anymore? No, they're not. Why? Why did I delete the line? Oh, silly, silly diagram. Here we go. Wonderful. One more line. Exit to main menu. We'll come off this corner and go. I should delete that and make that an arrow line instead. You can go up there. Delete that line and replace it with another arrow. Okay. I think that is a good start. Now I don't know if I want to do another menu. For like, should I do separate menus for what's in the control? I mean, like, your controls would obviously go to, like, what do you call it? They go to like a keyboard thing, but this is a card game. You're gonna be using your mouse to move the cards. I don't know what else you would use your your keyboard for. Well, you're really just clicking and dragging a mouse. So. Yes, I am making a card game. Okay, I guess I can show you. Let's get rid of this. Why has this become squished? What happened here? Hold on. There we go. Wonderful. I made a game design document, Bertel. It's a card game called Witches and Kittens, because that's what my brain came up with when I was coming up with the title. It's a trading card game. It's not really a trading card game. It's just a card game program. But the idea is to basically take cats, D&D, and card game-like things and combine it into a game. And it's had a lot of interesting things. Like, we came up with, like, I started this process, I think, at the beginning, or like at the end of January. It was like almost done. I only really work on it on a stream, just so it's like, it kind of pushes me to do it. But like, I think for like the past 5 weeks, I looked at what I wanted for like quote unquote enemies that you would fight. Could be like characters in the game that you would fight. They'd have their own cards and like themes. So act one is we got bird theme going on. Act two is like hares. Act three is frogs and toads, you know, typical familiars that a witch would have. And then there was a cat week I did. I mean, I didn't really take pictures of them. And then we did owls last week. Let's not do that. So that's what I've done. It's a slow process. Right now I'm just trying. If the diagram is like the last thing I need to like needs to go in this document. And then I'll be making a long form content video for my YouTube just on the overall process about how you go about designing a game. So, yep, planning a game before doing anything in a game is the best way to go. Just in my experience and everything that I've had with that. So, all right, we're gonna throw this back over here. That's not what I want. I think we say this becomes probably audio. I don't know what goes into audio. Obviously, there's lots of different other things. I can go into audio. Video, you obviously have like resolution and stuff like that and graphics. But I don't think. Why am I typing game design again? Video. So this would be like just like master volume. Probably like sound effects. I feel like those are like the two main things I foresee in this game. I don't know. That's probably it for that. Wonderful. Wonderful little diagram. Main menu, start game. Yeah, this would be like resolution, and like what is that level? I forget what it's called. It's like high. You go like low, medium, high, very high. What is that called in games? Why am I blanking on what that actually is supposed to be? What is that called? Graphics? No. Don't understand. Oh. My brain is drawing a blank. Low, medium, high graphic. Is it just graphics? Probably just graphics. Seems like the most standard thing. Yeah, probably. Probably just graphics. Bam. Bam. Ugh. Line. How did this get here? Why did a UML line get there? Okay. Audio, master volume, sound effects, video, resolution, graphics. Oh, isn't like brightness? Brightness might be part of it too. Like brightness and contrast. Probably those two go on there too. Contrast. Okay. Hey, undo that. You go in the middle. You go here. Grab another line and put it between graphics and brightness. Wonderful. Okay, is there anything else I want here? Settings. The settings menu is technically going to have the audio and video. Oh, that looks awful. Right. Okay. I think I know how I can do that. Never mind. I can't use this arrow from audio. Although I feel like actually, here's what we're going to do. I'm gonna take this box right here. Line it up with settings. Call this one settings as well. Because this technically, it holds everything we need. Send to back. I mean, it's just whatever that works. So basically settings is also going to have an audio and video. I don't know what else you would have for settings. Maybe like difficulty. Probably something else you would need. This needs to go to back. I don't know how to make this look better. Move it there. Take this dude, move it here. And send this one to the back. There we go. I think that is a solid plan for the menu flow. And we should save. Save. So, main menu has start game, save game, load game, settings, achievements, and exit to desktop. That is also what is missing from here is exit to desktop as well. Typically they allow you to do that from within the game. So I think that is a pretty solid plan for what we're going to do in terms of a menu. Like I said, this is going to be a short stream today. Got some other things I need to do as well, but this completes our wonderful, wonderful document. So, with that out of the way, we can move on to the next phase of game design, which I'm not entirely sure what it's going to be. If anything, There's a couple directions we could go in the future for where we want to go with the game design stuff. There's two routes I'm thinking. You could either go the art route or the programming route, and we'll probably end up going the programming route because that is what I'm most comfortable with. And it's because I feel like you can implement stuff much easier into... Basically, you can implement your features. Like, would they be features? Probably. Yeah. Your game design implementations. Oh, no. Blah, 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 blah. Your game design mechanics, you can implement that before you implement art or anything. You can just use placeholder materials for art. Like, you'd be gray boxing is essentially what it is, but we'd be gray boxing for a card game. But probably... We probably still will need to figure out, I mean, we could do that in the gray boxing, is figure out how the game board is going to look. What is that going to look like? I think that's a question we need to answer the next time we do this. And then we can go and start using Unity and whatnot and just make sure I have everything I need for Unity. I got all of the, like the IDE environment and stuff to work with set up already. I just gotta refresh myself on Unity because it's been such a long time since I've done anything with it. I haven't really made like anything 2D in Unity in a while. The last thing I made in Unity was like an MMO like camera, just because that was what I was trying to do at the time. But I think with that, I'm going to end stream, so thank you for joining me today, and I hope to see you on Thursday. I will be doing Risk of Rain 2 again, because that is my, I guess, guilty pleasure game. It's a great, fun roguelike that I enjoy playing. So, with that, I bid you adieu. Where's my... Ugh.